everyone, and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge, and I'm here today with musicteacher.com. And in this video, we're going to talk about warm-up exercises. I'm going to show you my five favorite warm-up exercises to get your fingers kick-started before every practice session and every performance. The tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my PRS S2 Studio, which is plugged into the Blackstar Studio 10 6L6. The amp is running today via the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X, and my voice is being recorded with a Sennheiser MKE-400 microphone. Warm-up exercises are very, very important for guitar players. They enable us to get our fingers moving before we do anything, be that playing at home for practice purposes or playing on stage. We should always warm our fingers up because that means we're never going to be straining ourselves, especially if we're trying to play something pretty difficult or pretty hard. We're not going to be pushing ourselves too far. The warm-up exercises will allow our muscles to relax and get up to our usual speed. If you've ever picked up your guitar and tried to play something pretty difficult and found that you've not been able to do it straight away, this is probably because you've not warmed up correctly. The concept of this is exactly the same reason that athletes warm up before they perform sport. We need to get our muscles loosened and warmed up and our coordination tightened up before we tackle the hard stuff. So I'm going to show you my five favorite warm-up exercises in this video. The first one is a nice simple one which uses chromatics. It's a four note per string idea, so we can do this both ascending and descending. It's going to sound like this. So all I'm doing here is I'm taking any note on the fretboard. I started this from the fifth fret, but you can start this wherever you want. And then what you're doing is you're playing four notes in a row on the same string, chromatically. So if you're playing the fifth fret as your starting point, your middle finger is going to play the sixth, your third finger is going to play the seventh, and your little finger is going to play the eighth. You can adapt this exercise to suit yourself based on how far you want to stretch. So if you start this higher up the neck, there's going to be less of a stretch between the fingers. And if you start this lower down the neck, there's going to be more of a stretch between the fingers. Most players, when they first start doing this kind of exercise, find it easy to start around the middle of the neck because the frets are slightly closer together, so the stretches aren't as big. And then as you get more comfortable with this and better at stretching, you can obviously move that out towards the first fret where the stretches are going to be much further apart. So as well as getting your fingers warmed up, this also helps with your coordination, both with your left and right hands. So I'm alternate picking this with my pick, down, up, down, up. So I'm playing 5, 6, 7, 8. Then I'm moving to the A string. And then I'm carrying that on for the rest of the strings. When I get to the top, I'm then just doing it backwards. So I'm now playing 8, 7, 6, 5. So as you do this going up, you could leave each finger in place, and then when you get to the top, you're then taking a finger away. The second exercise is the same idea where we're basing this off a chromatic pattern, but we're just going to mix the notes up slightly, so it's going to sound like this. So we're still using the same four chromatic notes there, and you can still move this up and down the fretboard to suit yourself. But what we're doing now is we're mixing up the order of the fingers. This is great for building finger independence. So this time I'm playing 5, 8, 6, 7. I'm still alternate picking. And then I'm still ascending through the strings. When I get to that final 7th fret on the high E string, I'm doing the same pattern now, but I'm just coming back to the lower strings. The third exercise is using these really angular sounding chords. Now this exercise doesn't sound like the most interesting exercise, but it is pretty tricky and it's great for getting your fingers to work together. So what we're doing, we're gonna start quite high on this one. I'm gonna play this chord shape. I'm gonna play 12 on the D string with my little finger, 11 on the G with my third, 10 on the B with my second, and 9 on the E with my first finger. And I'm gonna strum that chord. Then, I'm gonna keep in the same fretting position, but all my fingers are gonna switch. So I'm gonna do this. So now I've gone to 9 with the index finger on the D string, 10 on the G with my middle finger, 11 on the B with my third finger, and 12 on the E with my little finger. So that chord shape has become that chord shape. So I'm just rotating the entire hand. I'm still playing the same 4 frets, but I'm changing up the orientation of the fingers. Now, like I said, it's not the most exciting sounding exercise, but it's really good for finger independence and finger strength building. Once we've got it nailed in one position, we're then gonna move it down a fret and do the same thing, and then we're gonna keep moving it down the fretboard. So we're gonna do it here with our little finger at the 12th. And then we're gonna move it down, but flip back to the first shape, so our little finger's on the 11th. And then the 10th, and so on down the neck until we get to the first fret. So here's how it's gonna sound in full. The fourth exercise is going to be using a minor pentatonic scale shape. I'm going to be starting from an A note, so this is going to be an A minor pentatonic, but you can do this in whichever key you want. So the exercise is going to be going up the scale in different 4 note groupings, but those 4 note groupings are going to change direction as we go. So here's how it's going to sound in full. So I'm ascending and descending the scale, but I'm changing the direction of the groups. So I'm starting from the root note, and I'm going up 4 notes. Then I'm going up one more note, so this is my second grouping now, so we could view these as 16th notes, so 4 across every beat. When I get to this next note, I'm actually starting my second beat, so from here I'm gonna come back 4 notes. So it's up 4. That's my first beat, but then on the second beat I'm actually coming up one more note, but going back. I've landed now on the second note of the scale. Now I'm going to go to the third note of the scale and go up 4. And then I'm going to go up one more and come back. And now I'm on the fourth note of the scale. So I'm just doing these 4 up, up one more, 4 back. It's like an ascending and descending way of going up the scale. When I'm at the top, I can then reverse this, so I can come down 4, down one more and back up. Final exercise I'm going to show you is more of a rhythmic exercise. It's great for your picking rhythm, but also your own perception of rhythm. I find this really useful when I'm warming up just to get my head around a couple of different rhythms and obviously focusing in on certain beats. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our 4 beat bar and we're going to split it up into 16th notes. 1 E and a, 2 E and a, 3 E and a, 4 E and a. On each beat, we're going to play a note. So I'm just going to start with the 5th fret of the D string. So imagine that is 1, 2, 3, 4. On the 16th notes, the E and A, I'm going to play the same string, but muted. So we've got this continual 16th note pulse. 1 E and A, 2 E and A, 3 E and A, 4 E and A. But I'm playing a note on the beat and muting the ones in between. Now we're going to do it again, but we're going to move the beat. So now the beat's going to be on the E, so it's going to be 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and... Now we're going to move it again, so it's on the and, 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and... Finally, we're going to put it on the so it's 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and This is a great exercise for getting your rhythmic brain warmed up. It allows you to focus in on certain subdivisions within the beat. You can do it all over the neck with single notes or with chords if you want. It works great with triad style funk chords because you're going to be using a lot of these offbeats if you go into playing things like funk and soul. So if you do it with a triad chord, so I'm just going to use an A minor triad here on the 5th fret of the G, B, and E. It might sound like this. So on the beat. On the E, on the and, and on the You'll notice the direction that I'm picking the note or the chord changes depending on which subdivision it's on as well. If it's on the beat or it's on the end, it's a down, and if it's on the E or the A of the beat, it's on an up. So these five exercises are designed to get your fingers moving before any practice session or any performance. They're all very useful and they all actually add to your own skill set. So by doing all of these, you're actually building up different levels of coordination and finger independence as well. So even if you're not warming up for a gig, these are all very useful things to go away and practice. When you practice them, especially if you're new to this, it's very much advisable to start slow. So play these as slow as comfortable. Don't go too fast straight away because obviously you want to focus on the accuracy of what you're playing. You can do these all with a metronome as well, and practicing anything with a metronome is great just for getting it super tight, and it gives you a guide to how to get faster. So if you can play these really comfortably at a set speed on a metronome, then start to push the tempo of that metronome and work on the next layer of speed. And gradually over time, you'll see your speed increase more and more. So there you go. There are five really easy, really fun warm-up exercises to get your fingers going. Let us know down below in the comments how you've gotten on with those exercises, but also let us know what your favorite warm-up exercises are as well. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a music teacher in your local area, please head to musicteacher.com. Check out the database of teachers. There's a great network of teachers all around the UK waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.